Welcome to Game 1 between the Copenhagen Wolves and Meet Your Makers during Day 1 of the Battle of the Atlantic. Evelyn comes bot lane to try to snatch first blood.
Evelyn's already in the tribe, but it's going to come around, find each other. They've both got the double buffs on, and it's amazing they want to go for, but unfortunately they're going to back away. Libic, though, manages to land the hook, gets on towards Amazing. Amazing taking low. He's got nowhere to drop. He's going to come straight back down. Flashes away. Is it going to be first blood? Yes, it will. It's Libic that gets the double buff.
Libic's Thresh catches out Kha'Zix, and we see the true power of the white camp.
Pushes that lane and gets more siphoning strike stacks.
And you can see the pings coming down the bottom there. Copenhagen Wolves, the hook on towards Kautar. Will it follow through? Forces him to jump it away. That's going to be down for a long time. It's Unlimited that's getting caught out. A lot of damage going towards him. Not enough. Mega Inferno Bomb not going to take him down. Yes! No! The Spectrum took him down. The new minion.
It got aggroed.
Another nice Thresh Shook forces Copenhagen Wolves into a risky fight.
That's going to happen.
Kautar gets caught in. He's surely not going to get out of this one. Living though, Ace in the hole will come in. And Kautar jumps straight in and out to get away from that one. Wow. Mega Inferno Bomb actually doesn't really find his target. You can see Unlimited. He's going to go down around the side. But Kautar has to flash away from this one. Charu keeping those bombs going. Forgiven taking low. Kubon comes around the side. That's going to be Forgiven going down. Caitlyn is dropped. They're going to continue chasing. Youngbuck's in trouble now. He's got no mana. Kautar low. Kubon's going to chase on towards him. Kautar trying to create something, but instead he just walks straight into a giantly fed Mundo. Charu gets himself a kill. Amazing in trouble. This could be the ace for me or Makers. As Amazing gets tracked down, you're not going to escape those cleavers. And Kubon just taking chunks out of him. That's the ace and the triple kill for Kubon.
Perfectly timed flashes and Zonyas give Meet Your Makers the upper hand.
I am Mundo. I do go where I please. He's 6-1-1, but instead Makata's going to get caught out. Ace in the hole comes in. The Ignite should burn him down. Oh! Zonya's Arglass. Will he get saved? No. Timbers comes in. He flashes just at the right time. Cullen comes out, but instead Makler's in trouble.
No!
Hellturbo not landing. And now Kubon comes in around the side. Forgiven gets hooked in there. Kubon takes him down. Now he turns his attention towards Kautar. Kautar tries to come around. Makler's still poking from the side there. Another one flashes away. Kautar jumps out. He can't get a reset. He finally gets one, but Kubon is all over him like a rash, and Charu comes in, pots his own Zonyas, he gets the kill, they can turn this around, Charu gets in, Mega Inferno Bomb comes in, gets another one down, Kubon keeps the damage down, Youngbuck should have the damage, Makler's still waiting in the wings, trying to poke off from range, Amazing is so low, Kubon's regen, is he going to be enough to keep him at bay here? I don't think it is, they've had to leave him alone, Kubon now, look at him coming in, Makler comes back in, he's going to catch on towards him, Makler gets one, Youngbuck taking so low, he will eventually drop. Oh my god, it's a double kill for Makata. Back and forth action, but that is the ace for Meet Your Makers once again.
Once again, a beautiful death sentence sets up another fight.
For the promotion tournament into the LCS.
Yeah.
Oh, the hook!
The hook's going to go in, and actually Libic follows it through, throws the box down. It's going to be amazing with the Culling coming down on towards him. Mega Inferno Bomb will catch on towards Forgiven, and now the rest of the team, Amazing, is going to go down. The amount of damage that went on to Forgiven was incredible there. Makata comes around the side. Libic taken very, very low. Lucian does get dropped. Kautar tries to jump away. Not too sure. It's a battle in the top lane as meanwhile around the side, but Makata is going to follow on towards Kautar. It's a one-on-one, and there's only one winner there. Charu will get caught out. No! Not quite enough. Pops the Zonyas. He's safe again, and it's the third ace of the game for Meet Your Maker.
As we approach the hour mark, only 10,000 gold separates the two teams.
He's actually going a long way away, though, so he's going to come into this one. Meet Makers will start out. Kautar's going to be the focus target. Libic does get away. Kautar's gone down. They've managed to get Kha'Zix down, and Libic is low as well, just around the side there. And Kubon jumps straight on that one. Youngbuck being kited around. Makata's so low. Youngbuck will get dropped down here. It will be a kill towards him, and that's another one. Amazing now going down. Unlimited gets dropped in there. Forgiven so low. He tries to flash away, but gets caught out by the bullet of Makler. And that is surely the triple kill and the ace for Meet Your Makers.
And with the inhibitor already down, this is going to be the game one victory for MYM, D-Man. What a game. 56 minutes and another ace for them. That's 50 kills we have in the game all told.
So the Nexus turrets will be dropping. Meet Your Makers going to close this one out, no problem at all. But what a game it has been. 57 minutes into the game, and Meet Your Makers finally get themselves a victory. It was a hard-fought one.
As the game finishes, I would like to thank everyone for watching. If you enjoyed, feel free to like and subscribe. Also, stay tuned for more recaps coming this LCS season.